We Are Positive Products. I'm Michael. This is Tyra, Kate, Alonzo, and Aaron. So to start off, by show of hands, how many of you have a family member or know someone that has arthritis? Well, I know I did. Back when I was a kid, one of my very close family members had severe arthritis. This was him, Toby, my dog. When we were kids, our bond was unbreakable. We were inseparable, and we spent almost every minute together. Except that changed. When he got arthritis, he was unable to move, couldn't walk, and didn't have the same energy and connection that we had before. He was forced to take medication to mitigate the excruciating pain that he faced throughout the day. And like this, there are millions of other dogs that share the same problem and condition. Sadly, over 10.5 million dogs have crippling arthritis, and half of all dogs over the age of 10 do also. Except, there was no solution. Until now. Introducing the Barkritis Dog Vest. Our Barkritis Vest helps dog owners who want to extend their happy and healthy relationship with their dogs by addressing and treating their dog's arthritis unlike the unsuccessful solutions of before.
The percentage of dog arthritis won't increase without a solution like Barkritis Vest. A compression vest that is not only affordable, but encourages mobility and helps prevent and increase arthritis. It allows you, the owner, to invest in a product that is specified to maintain the joints in your dog's body and overall health. Not to mention, it'll save you an abundant amount of money compared to the money you would spend on surgery, prescription, and veterinary bills, all of which can range from $1,500 to $4,000 depending on the situation. Additionally, the vest has a retention compression technology that allows the dog movement. The spandex fabric will maintain the joints while stabilizing the stress that can cause arthritis in the dog. Furthermore, the vest also has a heat and cooling compartment where you are able to insert a heating and cooling pad to help reduce the risk of joint inflammation that can cause arthritis. With this and the retention compression technology will help alleviate the pain and not only the affected, but the potential dogs who may face arthritis.
The pet industry today is worth around $63 billion. In the past 20 years, that number has tripled. We can take a look at the vet healthcare and pet accessory market, which even that is valued at $40.2 billion. Based off of our previous sales, our projected market share by 2022 is valued at around $250.9 million. Now, even with such a unique product, we still have some competition. During times like these, families like to run to medication, even though it could be taking them a step backward, both health-wise and financially. When you run to medications, you run into dangerous side effects like liver, kidney, and even digestive failure. On top of it, they're super expensive and simply just inconvenient. Another competitor we face are orthopedic dog beds. These beds, while they are better than your average dog bed, they're simply just temporary. They don't alleviate pain permanently. It's only when the dog is physically on the bed, and they can range anywhere from $300 to $500. As you can tell, our product tackles every part of this industry, while our other competitors seem to fail in certain aspects. As of right now, our target is Amazon, because that's where we feel our product has the best potential. After we succeed there, we move on to big retailers like PetSmart, Petco, and even online retailers like Chewy.com. 44% of households in America today own a dog. Our target audience are all dog owners of any age, but let's not lose sight of the fact that as we age, so do our pets. In just 3 years, our dogs will have aged 21 years, and in six, they've aged 42. Now, in their new market today, we think the best approach to take is the social media approach. As you can see on Instagram alone, the hashtag Dogs of Instagram has already surpassed 106 million posts. We think the best strategy to take is to contact these big accounts and have them market our product, seeing as they already have such a high engagement.
We feel that spandex and double knit will be the best material to use for our product. And after getting quotes from material and shipping companies, our estimated value for our shipping and manufacturing is $8. And we set our retail price at $110, leaving us with $102 in gross profit. And we plan to garner the market. We plan to garner the market with our product because it is not as expensive as its alternative. And as you can see on the board, we plan to sell 150,000 units by our first year, and by our fourth year, 2 million units.
Now, to add on to Lonzo, the potential for our Barkritis vest doesn't Sure, the 43 million households across the world are a surefire market for our product, but it's important that we take a step back and think outside the box. Take, for instance, the millions of dogs across the world today that far exceed the title of just man's best friend. Take, for example, man's best security guard, man's best therapist, and even man's best eyes. You see, these dogs in these three industries serve a purpose, and our Bark Right is Best would greatly aid them by not only alleviating existing arthritic pain, but by preventing the onset of it. You see, this is both a proactive and reactive approach, which combined into powerful effects, such as making them more effective at their jobs, having them live longer, and saving people money. Now, not only does this make a happy dog, but makes for a happy dog owner and a happy wallet. But as I mentioned, not only does it serve sick dogs, but how do we intrigue this general dog population? Well, our company is taking what we like to call the double F approach, which is both functional and fashionable. With our 10 designs, we are combining the two superpowers of the pet industry, being pet cosmetics and pet health, into one superpower of a product. Now, why does this product mean so much to me? Well, the answer lies in this little goof of a furball right here. Her name is Carly. And ever since I was born, Carly has been right by my side all my life. Now, not only is she man's best friend, but she's my best friend. And I recall countless of times when she was sick, laying down on the floor, and I would pull my little pillow from my room just to sleep next to her, just to make sure she wasn't lonely at night. But although this relationship was filled with love, it didn't last. You see, Carly contracted arthritis at the young age of 11, and sadly, her life was taken away from me. But this case isn't exclusive to just Carly and me, to Toby and Mike. You see, there's over 10 million dogs today, just like Carly and Mike, who have arthritis, who are battling the same pain. But that shouldn't be the case, and it won't be. With our Bark Right is Best, our dog's best friend of a product will ensure that man's best friend stays that way. A best friend and not a heartbreak. Thank you.
How does it work?
I understand that it's a vest that goes around, but the main joints in the elbow and the wrist joints that you consume in a dog, and especially the back hip joints where hip dysplasia is probably your most common deformation orthopedically in a canine, how does it actually work as opposed to, say, a thunder bunny that really is just there providing compression as a vest to reduce stress in an animal versus actually treating?
That's a great question. So our compression technology maintains the ideal pressure range for the joints so that the degenerative condition of arthritis doesn't get worse. Because again, it is a chronic condition, not an acute one. So it's not like one injury and then the dog gets injured, but it's accumulative. So they can wear the vest over time and the dog won't get worse, but it'll prevent it from getting worse, if that makes sense.
And building on to what Newton said, when Tyra spoke about having the compartments, the sleeves of the compressive material for the hot and the cold packs, those are for the shoulders and for the hips. Because I don't know if we include, I believe we included it earlier, but the places that affects most of the dogs are the shoulders and the hips. So that's where we have made sure to have it. Unlike other products that might cool the whole body or heat the whole body, because the dog can tell you if it's too hot or cold. But if you're just acting on those certain joints, then you can make sure that they're still at a normal temperature, but you're still taking account for those.
So I thought this presentation was great, and I especially liked the story that was, like, it was great because it just really appealed to my emotions. There's a dog, so, you know, like,
did arthritis actually kill this dog? I felt like we were talking about dogs dying a lot. I didn't know that arthritis led to dogs dying, actually, which I felt like we had something you could have talked about a little more in the problem. And so that's what that leads to, because when I think of arthritis, maybe it's just me not being informed about arthritis, but not really thinking about dogs that are dying. But that's bad enough to be by us.
So I have two questions. Does it make the dog have to work harder in compressing its joints?
No, it doesn't. The dog is actually still able to move around regularly. It's just that while they have the compression vest on, it's activating the joint, so they won't get any arthritis if they get joint inflammation. The vest is already working on a solution, so they won't get up. So they are able to move around.
Additionally, actually, great question. And it's similar to like a shooting sleeve in basketball. Although it might seem like it restricts movement or makes it harder, it's actually just holding the joint together, compressing it. And it's not necessarily like other materials like weave, joist, spandex, and double knit, because those are things that flex laterally, and they're not going to restrict movement. They're just going to help compress your joints.
And the second question is, you said Amazon has the best potential. Why?
I would like to say this. So what we're doing is called a validate first strategy. So what we're doing is hitting the easily accessible markets of Amazon. So we've been fulfilled by them, and now we're gonna get validated by our customers. So they have the potential to leave customer feedback as well. So it builds our reputability, and then we're gonna hit the targets that are less accessible, such as PetSmart, PepsiCo, and even online retailers.
But why specifically over Chewy? I use Chewy.
Right. We feel like it makes sense to focus on just one distributor at first rather than two, so we can hone in on making as much profit as possible in that one market, and then we will expand in the future.
And also building on to what Aiden said, we felt a special place for Amazon, given that if we become a fulfilled by Amazon seller, we can take advantage of Amazon Prime, which is such an amazing asset to a product that we're trying to introduce to the market. Since I know for me, at least myself and a lot of us here, when we go to Amazon, that's like where we buy almost everything, right? Because of how cheap we can get it, and also we can get that in 2 days. And that also takes care of a lot of logistics that we have to worry about otherwise, because since we're shipping it to their warehouses, they fulfill it for us, and they can also ship it and manage the logistics of it, and also the return process.
So I got one quick last question. When you're dealing with older dogs, number one killer is going to be dehydration as they get older, regardless of what issue they have. And the only way for a dog to cool off is by panting. If this is compressing their lungs and their ribs at an elderly age, is that going to make it more difficult for them to breathe? Because that's different than a more intricate type of movement that they go on.
That's a great question. Actually, our product was tested by the APPA, which is the American Pet Products Association, and they confirmed that our product actually doesn't compress it to the ability where it restricts your lungs. That makes sense. It only maintains the ideal pressure range for